And the Purdue Boilermakers have knocked off the Tennessee Volunteers in overtime at the Music City Bowl.
I'm proud of these guys, man. I really am. Disappointed in tonight. The journey is way more important than the destination in some respects. But, man, this journey's been awesome with these guys.
The journey. It starts with the vision.
I'm here because we have the opportunity to go chase championships on the football field.
A plan to change everything you've ever known about hard work, drive, dedication, and then take it to the next level. It's not easy.
No!
You will fail, but failure is not the end. It is a chance to grow.
Every little thing matters.
And if you embrace the journey, after all the pain, all the trials, all the setbacks, you reach your destination. But guess what? It's not over. Instead, a new journey begins.
I want to welcome Josh, and you'll meet his wonderful family. Really excited about having you all here.
Anytime as a head coach you come into to a program, you're gonna talk about the things that you wanna do.
We're gonna play with tempo here. We're gonna be the aggressor. We wanna be physical. We wanna dominate the line of scrimmage.
We was kind of trying to just stick together. He's one of those coaches that you could tell was genuine and actually cares about you on and off the field.
Play this game. It's a tough, physical, demanding game. You play it because of connection.
Connection. It's the foundation of any strong football team. When a new coach comes to town, he better connect quickly because spring practice comes at you fast.
One's up, two's behind.
Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Hustle, hustle, get off, get up, get up, get up.
Back down, right back down.
Good ball.
Last spring, going into spring ball, I really didn't know what to expect. It's a new coaching staff, new offense, new system. Biggest adjustment was the speed, trying to get used to the tempo, trying to get used to going fast.
I love what we did last year in our ability to grasp the fundamentals of the technique, to grasp the system and understand or start to begin to understand the way that we wanted to play.
The whole team had definitely started believing in and bought in.
That is a winning mentality. That's who we got to become.
It's kind of like we're all just building that family bond. Everybody's just come closer together.
Once the foundation is built, it's time to put it to test.
Back at Neyland Stadium as tonight the Tennessee Volunteers open the 2021 football season as they host the Bowling Green Falcons. And what a setting it is.
Hey, adversity brings us closer. Compete your ass off, cut it loose, go more.
They have formed the tee, the anticipation building, the excitement, and for the first time, Josh Heupel leads the Tennessee Volunteers running through the tee at Neyland Stadium.
There's nothing like playing in front of the 102, 455 in Neyland Stadium.
This crowd is properly hyped. Orange and white, checkered overalls all over the place, and they all rallied right here.
It just reminded all of us, like, why we came to Tennessee.
Bex and Brooks will get us started. Riley Keller deep to receive. Welcome back, college football. Taking a couple of shots in the end zone, and this one's hauled in. Tennessee touchdown, Cedric Tillman.
I love the intensity and the competitive nature from our football team. That was true in the first ball game, but man, as we grew throughout the entire season.
Growth. Let's just call that the story of 2020.
I really felt like from the opening kickoff until the last second left the clock, every Saturday afternoon, we played as hard or harder than our opponent.
Tennessee bringing out the dark mode uniforms. Hooker's got a wide open Velus Jones inside the 10. Another touchdown by Tennessee.
It was something about those black unis, man. I turned on the film. He was flying around every snap of the ball. It was 11 guys to the ball every play. And that game, just that's when we flipped the switch and we knew that it could be one of the best defenses in the country.
That's what hard work gets you. Confidence, all the film, the lifts, the practices. It all gets you to the biggest stage in college football.
All week, that's all anybody in Big Orange Country has talked about, this matchup tonight between the Tennessee Volunteers and the Ole Miss Rebels.
We're playing smart. You with me? Come after them for 16 minutes.
keep pounding that damn thing and all the time. Let's go, man.
They haven't had the building full like this in quite some time. A thunderous roar at Neyland Stadium as the Tennessee Volunteers come running through the tee on a Neyland Saturday night.
I feel like Ole Miss specifically, the crowd had a big role in the game.
How loud is it?
It's loud, Tom. It's the loudest stadium I've been in this year.
That was probably the loudest games I've ever played in.
The noise.
The tackles could barely hear Corral.
The sheer noise that was there on that Saturday night, and it's unlike anything in college football.
Can't afford to take a sack. Fires! Intercepted!
He was scrambling out the pocket, and he threw the ball, and I just seen the ball like coming right to me. And my eyes got so wide, and when I caught it, I literally got up and like just looked around, and the amount of energy that was going through the fans and going through the stadium was crazy. That was the most electric thing I've ever seen.
The journey's never smooth. Every path leads to bumps in the road, but without struggle, there is no progress. No one expects an easy road. There will be obstacles, but how will you overcome them? That's the growth.
To the 40, Alante Taylor.
The thing that this team continued to develop and grow in is the ability to reset.
Hooker throws to the back corner of the end zone. Touchdown, Cedric Tillman. Tennessee comes up with a huge win on the road as they beat the Kentucky Wildcats.
Coach Heupel and his staff made an immediate impact on Rocky Top. This team went from 108th to 7th in scoring offense. They scored more touchdowns than any team in school history. And they did it all while going fast. One play every 2.99 seconds. And this defense, they were 2nd in the SEC with 102 tackles for loss. This was good enough for 7th in the nation. And in 2022, with over 80 players returning, the next journey is about to begin.
I think we're just beginning to understand who and what we can become. In year two, we're so much further ahead in accountability of who we are, trusting the people that we're with every single day, and the way that we respect and go about attacking every single day.
A successful spring football for me, honestly, just our whole team pulling in the right direction. Everybody going to class on time. Everybody being me is on time, doing extra work, doing everything right. Because when it comes down to the wire, when it comes down to the small little details, we gonna know deep down that throughout, not just during the season, but off season too, that we gave it our all and we did everything right.
Came back for a reason. Wanted to touch up a few things so I can become the best receiver possible. But you gotta remember what got us here, what made us a top 10 offense in the country. And now we're trying to take that next step and becoming the number one offense in the country.
The key for us moving forward, all right, the key for us moving forward is don't ever make the same mistake twice. If we don't do that, you accept coaching, right? You incorporate it into your game. The distance that we will travel will take us right where we want to be.
Brotherhood, connection, family. The journey to the top starts now, and you can only see it on the juice.